Τα παπαγαλάκια των μίντια οργιάζουν. Ο λαός τρομοκρατείται, όμως κάποιες ελεύθερες φωνές λένε την αλήθεια.
Η Ελλάδα πλέον δεν είναι ανεξάρτητη με βάση αυτή τη σύμβαση. Και όχι μόνο δεν είναι ανεξάρτητη στην εξωτερική πολιτική, διότι τη δεσμεύεται η εθνική κυριαρχία, αλλά και στην οικονομική πολιτική λόγω της δέσμευσης της εθνικής περιουσίας. Εγώ έχω πει ότι όταν είδα τον όρο της παραίτησης από την εθνική κυριαρχία, τον πρώτο όρο που είδα, δεν πίστευα στα μάτια μου, διότι δεν έχει ξαναγίνει ποτέ. Τέτοιος όρος δεν έχει μπει ποτέ σε διεθνή σύμβαση. Και έχω πει επανειλημμένως ότι ένας τέτοιος όρος δεν υπογράφεται ούτε με το πιστόλι στον κρόταφο. Είχε και μια άλλη διάταξη η οποία παραβίαζε το πολίτευμα της Ελλάδος. Παραβίαζε δηλαδή το εξής, έγραφε το 38, ορίζει ο 38-47, ο 35-47 συγγνώμη, 35-47, ότι δεν απαιτείται κύρωση των συμβάσεων από τη Βουλή. Ήρθε δηλαδή ένας απλός νόμος να καταργήσει το Σύνταγμα. Το ζήτημα είναι ότι υπάρχει μια διαρκής παραβίαση του πολιτεύματος της Δημοκρατίας. Αυτή τη στιγμή η εξουσία που ασκείται στο εσωτερικό με βάση αυτές τις ανυπόστατες συμβάσεις οι οποίες δεν πέρασαν από τη Βουλή των Ελλήνων σημαίνει ότι ασκείται μια πραξικοπηματική εξουσία, μια κατοχή και ακόμη και η εξουσία της Τρόικας που έρχεται και ελέγχει την ελληνική διοίκηση και εξευτελίζει καθημερινώς την Ελλάδα είναι παράνομη.
Έχουμε το στρατιωτικό πραξικόπημα και έχουμε το οικονομικό πραξικόπημα. Το πραξικόπημα μένει. Είναι υποχρεωμένος να τους πιάσει αυτούς τους Τρόικα και να τους στείλει πίσω. Μας έχουν τυλίξει σε μια κόλλα χαρτί αυτοί όλοι. Γιατί πιστεύω ότι είμαστε κοπάδι. Έτσι και δεν είμαστε κοπάδι και γρέψουμε, μόνο με τη δύναμη μπορούμε να μείνουμε πάνω.
Δείτε πώς αντιδρά στο άκουσμα του μνημονίου ένας γνώστης της ιστορίας και του οικονομικού παρασκηνίου, ο δημοσιογράφος Max Kaiser.
As we've been saying on this show from the beginning, the objective of the outside forces, that being the IMF, which is controlled by the US, which is controlled by Wall Street, is to simply grab all of Greece's assets for pennies on the dollar and to annex the entire country of Greece. And that they should forego their sovereignty and their independence. Now they're just one more ride on Disneyland. Congratulations, Greece. You're now insignificant. Your entire 5,000-year history just got flushed down the toilet.
Το ταπεινωτικό μνημόνιο ανοίγει τον ασκό του αιώλου και το κατευθυνόμενο προπαγανδιστικό παραλήρημα κατά της Ελλάδος και του λαού της παίρνει διαστάσεις χιονοστιβάδας. Προεξάρχοντες οι Γερμανοί με ανιστόρητες αναφορές και σχόλια νεοναζιστικού τύπου.
Danke, Harald. Ja, um das heutige Griechenland besser zu verstehen, da müssen wir weit, weit, weit zurück, nämlich bis in die Antike. Denn der Erfindungsreichtum der alten Griechen prägt bis heute unsere Kunst, aber natürlich auch unsere Kultur. Sie erfanden den Analverkehr. Den Aufstieg Griechenlands ermöglichte die damals vorherrschende Bescheidenheit. Nur in einer Tonne lebte der berühmte Philosoph Horo. Völliger Quatsch. Diogenes natürlich. Die alten Griechen haben aber auch ganz Europa militärisch gerettet. Ja, denn sie schlugen die Perser bei der Schlacht von Salamis. Glück gehabt. Danach war 2000 Jahre erstmal Schicht im Schacht. Kultureller Höhepunkt seit Homers Odyssee. Costa Cordalis rette das griechische Erbe, wird Dschungelkönig bei RTL. Den Beitritt zum Euro haben sich die Griechen natürlich nur erschlichen, denn sie versteckten sich im trojanischen Sparschwein. Und was soll ich sagen, drin ging's drunter und drüber. Das Problem ist, die Vetternwirtschaft lähmt den Staat. Griechenland leidet unter einer massiven Beamtenschwemme. Die EU setzt die Griechen natürlich jetzt unter Druck. Athen muss sparen. Und falls das nicht funktioniert, dann schicken wir neben ihm hier noch ein paar andere Altlasten rüber. Vorsicht. Wenn es bei den Griechen jetzt trotzdem nicht hinhaut, kann ja passieren, dann ein konstruktiver Vorschlag jetzt für die EU. Einfach Griechenland an die Türkei verkaufen. Da freuen sich alle und früher oder später haben sie sich ganz doll lieb.
Ο Max Kaiser ξεμπροστιάζει όσους μιλούν για χρεοκοπία της Ελλάδας. Αποκαλύπτει με επιχειρήματα την απάτη και περιγράφει πώς η χώρα μας και όχι μόνο αποτελεί θύμα των επιθέσεων της οικονομικής τρομοκρατίας.
The question for the Greek government is why no arrests of Goldman Sachs bankers. You know, in the Netherlands yesterday they talked about banning Goldman Sachs. In the United Kingdom they're talking about banning Goldman Sachs. In the United States the SEC now is got a case pending for fraud against Goldman Sachs. Goldman Sachs is the one that got Greece to skirt the Maastricht Treaty to join the euro with accounting fraud. These debts were all created under fraudulent inducement, and the Greek people have no responsibility to pay them back whatsoever. And what we're seeing right now is a classic case of financial terrorism. The IMF is holding out a package of monetary relief, which they say, well, we have it here for the Greek people to take, while at the same time, the bankers and the hedge funds are attacking the Greek bond market, forcing the yields up to 8.5%,
soon to be
9%.
You talk about the bankers and the investors. It's an assassination. What about the actions of the Greek governments, past Greek governments? And Martina was pointing out that there have been a series of bad decisions, there have been mismanagement, there have been misrepresentation about the financial status, and they didn't abide by EU rules.
The people should seek a regime change in Greece if the Greek government's in bed with Wall Street bankers. That's tyranny. But my point is that Greek economy has been targeted by the banks on Wall Street, including Goldman Sachs, for 10 years. To say that, well, it was only $2 billion initially, that's the defense of a rapist. And to say that it was only $2 billion is saying, well, they were just a little bit pregnant with massive fraud that has just escalated over the past 10 years. Goldman Sachs and the Wall Street banks already own now, I believe, the lottery system and the airport fees. They're going to go after other income-producing aspects of the Greek economy. They're going to bust it out. It's arsonism. They want to burn that Greek economy down. They want to control the income-producing properties, and they're going to move on to the next weakest link in the eurozone, probably Portugal. The Greek people need to stand up to financial terrorism or lose their freedom and sovereignty. It's as simple as that.
Greece is now in a position where it looks likely that it's going to have to activate this loan, this emergency rescue package mechanism. What about the small print to that? Because the devil's in the detail, isn't it?
Well, that's what I'm trying to say, Julie. It's a stealth takeover of all the income-producing assets of Greece, and they're using this current bond crisis, which is manufactured by Wall Street and the hedge funds. The crisis is manufactured. It's not a natural, organic crisis that's happening from just on its own. It's a controlled assassination of the Greek bond market by financial terrorists. Is the Greek government appeasing terrorism? It's exactly what they're doing. The Greek people need to seek a regime change and get rid of this government because they're in bed with the financial terrorists.
Okay.
Or lay down. Really, let me explain something to you. 6 months ago, John Paulson sat down with Goldman Sachs bankers in Greece, took a picture of the situation, and started to short Greek bonds. This is the same John Paulson who's now named in the lawsuit, the SEC, against Goldman Sachs for massive market abuse, market manipulation.
Don't you get it? They picked Greece as a hit, and they're destroying it because they want to take it down. There's no out. There's no way out of this.
Let's start with this possibility that George Soros might be possibly causing the demise of the euro. It started with a secret meeting. Go ahead and take it away.
I think we have now powerful circumstantial evidence that would put any investigator right on the trail. It's an attempt to create a new world monetary crisis. It's economic warfare to defend the dollar by attacking Greece and through Greece attacking the euro. And the thing that's been revealed now in the last couple of days by the Wall Street Journal is a secret dinner at a Manhattan townhouse on February 8th, which was attended by a group of hedge fund predators. And these sociopaths, over a dinner of filet mignon, planned a speculative attack on Greek bonds and the euro using leverage rates of 20 to 1. And who was there? Moness, Crespi and Hart, a boutique investment bank, SAC Capital Advisors, Greenlight Capital, Brigade Capital, and above all, Soros Fund Management. Now, Soros had been preparing the ground, saying he thought that the euro was in danger of falling apart and breaking up. And the idea is to organize a bear raid against the euro as a means of relieving the speculative pressure against the dollar. And, of course, Greece is the weak flank. They say that the consensus around this table over the filet mignon, any outcome of the Greek debt crisis is going to be very bad for the euro. And then they go on to say in this Wall Street Journal account that as soon as you get Greece going, that's the first domino. After that comes Spain, Portugal, Italy, Ireland, and, of course, California and Great Britain and, indeed, the United States. And one of the people, the guy from Brigade Capital, said Greece will be a contagion that will infect all the sovereign debt in the world. In other words, government debt, national, state, local, provincial, of all national states. So we're getting towards a situation where it's either the hedge funds and the zombie banks will drive the national governments into bankruptcy, or the governments will put these hedge funds into receivership and protect themselves. Now, this is only one of a couple of cabals that were mentioned by the Wall Street Journal. Another one is Paulson and Company. It's different Paulson. It's not the same Paulson.
Hank Paulson.
GlobeOp Financial Services. And then we have a group of zombie banks, all of them surviving because of U.S. taxpayer money. That would be Goldman Sachs. They couldn't be out of it. Bank of America Merrill Lynch and Barclays Bank. And remember, they were saved by the U.S. through AIG derivatives payments. So a lot of these people, of course, there to make money, but there's also a political purpose. It's to mask the weakness of the dollar. The dollar reached a low in the first week of December after falling all during the fall at about $1.50, 51 to a euro. Since then, the euro has been losing. So it's a support operation for the dollar. Now, the London Economist and the Wall Street Journal and the Financial Times have all been mocking the Greeks and Prime Minister Zapatero of Spain, who has talked about international speculative conspiracy. They say, look, you guys are paranoid. This is conspiracy theory. But here we have it. What we have in front of us is a, I think under U.S. antitrust law, this may fulfill the definition of a criminal conspiracy and restraint of trade. And if they were doing this in the U.S. stock market, that would be a pool, and that would be illegal. So I think it's clear that what Greece needs is not austerity, but they need to do things like ban derivatives. They need to outlaw credit default swaps.